let's get started again now. On our backs. Alright. We are going to do a lying hamstring stretch. So come down to your backs. So it's nice and long. You're going to breathe one leg up and it's going to be a little pulse higher. And then we switch. So it goes one, two, switch. You're like that. One, two. So if you want, you can breathe out each time you do your leg and then breathe out and then breathe in on the switch. Nice. One more each leg. Bring that leg a little bit closer. Now we're just going to do a pelvic tilt on the floor. So you want to tuck your hips, press your back down. And let's start with a bent knee tilt. So knees are bent, not much resistance. We're just trying to really engage, squeezing our belly button through our spine, keeping it nice and tight as possible. So we can really engage through our abs to start. And release down, neck comes down. Now we're gonna do it one more time. We're gonna make it a little bit harder by doing straight leg. Breathing up. Remember, back is flat. Just squeeze the leg, your hands underneath. And just flex really hard. Like you're trying to tuck your stomach in. Hold it out for 5 more seconds. 3, 2, 1, come on up. Let's turn around now, up sitting on our butt. We're gonna bend knee at one knee in front of us. Bring one leg to the side. You might already feel a stretch in that leg. Deepen it in our front leg by just leaning forward a little bit. And then coming up after a breath. So the idea is to sink down until you feel that stretch in your glute. Releasing, inching down. Pressing that knee and foot into the ground. And then up, let's do it one more time. And back up, let's go ahead and switch. So you can just bring your foot around and then back out, sitting up nice and tall to start. Knees bent, 90 degrees, ankles 90 degrees, and let's lean forward again. And up, so we're just taking a nice slow breath. And up, let's stretch it out one more time for that hip. And come on up. Now we're gonna go a little bit further up onto the knees, bent on all fours. And what we're gonna do is some hip circles. So first, leg comes up, out to the side, and then down. Making a big circle with our hip. Neutral spine. One more in that direction. Then let's switch it around. So out to the side first, then back, then down. Opening up the hips a little more. One more big hip circle. And then let's switch other side, starting with up, out, down. That's it, getting that leg all the way up to the side. One more. And reverse directions, out to the side first, back and down. And one more, stay here. We're gonna breathe in, arch our spine, look up. As you breathe out, we're going to round our back, tuck our tailbone. Make space between the shoulder blades. Let's do it again. This is our cat cow. We're just warming up the spine. One more. And out. Next, what we're gonna do is prep and tuck your toes under and lift up the knees ever so slightly, holding that. You're gonna feel a little bit more engagement, heat entering the body. Maybe in your quads. Core, ideally, we're gonna kick it up a notch for our core by just adding some slow shoulder taps. Opposite arm to the opposite hand. And let's try and stay as still as possible with our body. using our core to keep us in place. Shoulders over wrists, hips right over knees. And one more tap. All right, now we're gonna press it back up to a down dog. Stretching out the hamstrings a little bit. Sinking the hips back, and let's walk it out. So just bending one knee, then bending the other. You should feel that stretch in this leg, a little hamstring stretch. To walk it out a few more. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a big step to bring one hand to the outside of the hand. And then we're gonna drop that knee, come on up, stretch the hip flexor, sinking into it. So you should feel it right through here, right in front of that hip, maybe reaching up tall. And then let's switch legs, standing up, sinking in on the other side. Going to that point to where it's good for you. Nice long reach on that side. Let's do one more hip flexor stretch on each side. All right, switch last time. All right, next we're ready to fully stand up. We're gonna go to a side lunge. Feet wide, sinking down side lunge. Walking over with your hands. Side lunge on the other side. Maybe grabbing that ankle with that close hand. One more each side. And then one more on this side. All right, stretch what you need now. Let me show you how this is gonna work for the beginning of class. We're gonna do 1 minute intervals. First minute is gonna be a kickback. So all fours position, straight up, straight down. We're gonna do 1 whole minute on each leg. After that, we go into 1 minute of a hip thrust. So we're down on the ground, feet come in, hips coming up, 1 minute. Then to finish off, we're gonna do this move, which is gonna be a forward and back lunge. We're gonna step back into a lunge, knee over ankle. Then we're gonna step up into a forward lunge, back and forward. You can see my left leg is staying in that same spot. It's not even moving, it's just coming up onto the heel. And then we're just gonna switch and make the right leg the pivoting foot. So, that was a long circuit. So we're gonna start with those kickbacks. So if you can make your way onto the ground and that all fours position like you started, grab some water now because it's going to be a long circuit. And let's get started. 10 seconds and we're in. We're going to be kicking back with our left leg to start. So stack those hips over the knees and let's go. 3, 2, 1, and up. Keeping that knee bent at a 90 degree angle. And when we get to the top, what we want to do, squeeze the glute. All right, this is our chance to really connect to the glute here. We're priming with this, so that when we go into the other movement, we'll already have pre-fatigued their glutes, and they'll have to work even harder. So make sure you get up, squeeze it. Keeping that leg bent. Really connecting to that muscle here. So get your that's it, guys. We're going to keep it up for 15 more seconds. Then we just switch legs. You don't even have to move. We go right into it. No rest. I'm telling you now, we're going to switch in 3, 2, 1. Switch legs right in. Don't stop. You probably feel a little burn in one side of your leg, so let's make it even. Remember to squeeze at the top. Don't rush that. A nice little pause. Good. Halfway there. Keep it up, guys. move when I tell you is gonna be a hip thrust. So we're gonna turn over onto our back, press up with both legs at the same time. Keep it up! 5 seconds and we switch. Get ready. One, turn right over. Try and make it quick. And then we press up. So remember, we want our feet in close to our body. You should be able to almost reach them with your hands. And remember to press up. Lead with the hips. Every time. Tilting that spine. And pressing, digging those heels into the ground. Remember to squeeze at the top. That's it, full extension, hips towards the ceiling. When I count you down, we're up, standing, we got those lunges. 10 more seconds. Bring that knee almost to the floor, then we step forward, the weight shifts into our right leg, and then we press back. A little bit of coordination on this one to start. Up next, it's that our right leg that's going to be the pivot long leg. And in this circuit, there's going to be no rest. I know that sounds daunting, but the reality is that the kickbacks are something that don't raise our heart rate, so we're going to use that period as recovery, even though we're working on kids. All right, 15 more seconds. Remember those 90-degree angles at this time. All right, we're going to switch to our right leg. 3, 2, 1. That's now our pivot leg. Keep it there. Remember, chest should never be dropping on them. It stays up tall, pretty much. Awesome work, Harlan Ellis. All right, we've got 30 more seconds. After this, we're down on the ground again. Circuit starts over, left leg kickbacks. Seconds, guys. I'm a sorry sucker, and this happens all the time. And three, two, one, drop right down in off course position. Let's go right into it. Left leg. Rising up. You're gonna feel a little of the burn on your lips sooner this round. Alright, keep going with this kick back. Halfway there. Remember, get that knee all the way up. We want it level with the hip. So don't stop here. Make sure you pick it all the way up. More seconds, guys. Then we're right on our backs for those hip fronts, glute bridges. All right, 3, 2, 1, roll over. Rolling up one good time, hips, then the rest of your spine, then it's the last thing to come down. So really focus on that tilt of the pelvis. That's it, focusing on squeezing the glutes all the way to the ceiling. If your feet slide out, just bring them back in. Walk them back in. Good, press those knees out wide if they cave. We want to keep them strong out. Upper lunges, 20 seconds. Control here. No need to rush it. Let's just control the movement, connecting to our glutes on every lunge. Back to the whole goal with this. dancing at the top. Keep it up. We've got 20 more seconds, then we're into the blue bridges. Rolling up, flip the spine, then we press up. We're using our heels to press into the ground and get our hips closer to the ceiling. Full extension. Remember to pause at the top, down nice and slow, control. Good, pull those shoulder blades back. Really focus on this one. If you focus, you will feel a burn. Keep that up. Ten more seconds. Get ready to get up for lunges. All right, three, two, one. Step it on up. Lunges. Nice sharp 90 degree angles, don't forget it. Just give me a try. Just give me a try. Now, if you guys have noticed, you can take little baby steps here, then here, back to the middle. Or you can just go for the big step all the way across, all the way back. It requires a little more stability in that hip of the stable leg, so a little bit harder. We just got our right side to go. We're gonna switch in 10 more seconds. Three, two, one, root that foot into the ground. Let's do lunges on this side to finish up for the last minute of this circuit. Some girls feel best in the tiny dresses. Some girls. Nice, and that reverse lunge, feel that stretch of the glute. Dig that heel in to help you rise, don't forget. Remember, I always say it's not always how fast you lift, what you're doing, but how you're lifting. Are you making your body use the right muscles? How are you lifting? We're not even really lifting anything, but how are you training? Keep it up, 10 more seconds, then we rest. Let's get some good reps in. All right, three, two, one, step it up, shake it out. Good work, our first glute circuit is done. So grab some water here. That was 15 minutes of work with no break, good job. Okay, so we just did some glutes. Now, we're gonna work the core, so. We got a little circuit here. Let me set up my timer because we've got 40 seconds on, and then it's just going to be 40-second intervals the whole time. Yeah. So here are the moves. First move on the back, alternating V up. So we're down. One leg is going to come up, and we're going to reach for that leg. Then it comes down. Reach the other leg, just like that. Now. It's going to be a little easier if you let the opposite leg rest on the ground every time. See that? But if you choose to hover the leg, it's going to be a lot more intense. Keep that in mind. Second move, Russian twist. Come out the low back, elevate the feet, twist. If you'd like, you can hold something in your hand, like a little water bottle, and make sure it touches the ground every side. Then, we got scissor kicks down on the back, little kicks right here, and then we're going to come over plank position. We're going to do cross mountain climbers, so we're going to bring the opposite knee to the opposite elbow and back. If you cannot hold a plank on your toes, what you're going to want to do is come down to your knees and you're gonna have to go out to the side, which is perfectly fine. All right, lots of moves. We're starting alternating D up. So come down to your dax. And remember, 40-second intervals, no rest in between, no rest at the end, so just move through it quickly. All right, we're gonna start with the D ups in 6 seconds. So come down to the ground. And 3, 2, 1. One leg comes up, tap it, and then come back down. That's it. If you can, try and keep the legs straight. But if you need to keep them bent, that's fine. That's it, really using your core here. So remember to flex nice and tight, like we practice in the warm-up. Up next, we've got Russian twists. Just letting you know. So keep this move up for 10 seconds. We're gonna go right into it. 3, 2, 1. So you wanna come up, hover your feet, and tap it nice and slow, feeling that twist. All the way across your abs, really try and get that opposite hand down. That's why I can help to hold something, so you know that that touches the ground fully every time. If you want to make it more intense, straighten the legs. If that's too much, bend them, and if that's still too much, feel free to just set them on the ground and just twist. You have different options there. Either way, keep moving for 10 more seconds. Scissor kicks is our next move, so that one on our backs. And 3, 2, 1, come down to the back. Elevate your feet, slide your hands on your butt for support if you'd like. And we got little kicks. It's gonna be a little harder if you keep them low. If you need it a little bit easier, keep them high. You can rest your neck if you'd like. If that is hard for you, keep your neck up.
Just make sure to keep bracing with your abs. That's the most important thing. You should be feeling in your abs, not your back.
Push it out. We're in plank position next. So go ahead and roll over. 3, 1, roll right over. Plank position. So shoulders over wrist, butt tucked, cross, not in front or across. Move the elbow. Challenge. Can you get your feet touched? Good contraction in the abs if you have. Now, if you need to drop down to your knees, just come out to the side. Make sure you still maintain a good plank. We don't want our butts to droop or come up like this or arch. So if you're doing any of those, just drop down to your knees. We only got 5 more seconds. 3, 2, 1, pull it down the rest. All right, rapid fire for the abs. Second is rest. So really just grab some water, catch your breath. We're one time through that circuit, so you've got 2 more rounds to go. All right, 15 more seconds. When we come back in, starting with that alternating V up. All right, get ready, because we've got 5 more seconds.
Down on your backs.
Yeah, so you guys ready? Right. 1, 2. That's it. Get that leg
all the way up.
Keep going with that. Nice. More seconds. I've heard that you're happy and maybe it's selfish of me to watch you back this time. I know we've decided. Russian twists are next. 3, 2, 1. Come on up, hover. If you are, if you need to let them rest for a second, keep twisting. Oh, a nice front across the core. So this is working a little bit more into our sides of our abs that help us rotate. Keep it up. 10 more seconds, then we got scissor kicks. butt.
Good. Keep breathing throughout this. Breathing and bracing. Most important things.
If you need to raise your feet, go ahead and do that.
I know that burn is kicking in. Keep it up, guys. There's only one more move in the circuit. Good work. You got 10 more seconds. So calm, make your way down to your back. Alternating V-ups. 3, 2, 1, go. Nice work. Only 10 more seconds, then Russian twists are next. Three, two, one, come on up. Remember, straight leg harder, bent knees a little bit easier. The full twist all the way across, that will get you. Scissor kicks next. All right, get ready to go to the scissor kicks in 3, 2, 1, lower down. Great feet, let's go. A little bit more into the glutes. We're gonna work the
side planks a little bit now. So I'm going to stick with that 40 second interval, but it's going to be a little bit shorter. So we're just going to do in a side plank on one side. So that's where we got our skull stack right over the elbow. You can press up and slam your knee and get that hip high, or you can extend onto the toes. And what we're going to do here is we're going to do a hip raise. So hips come down and then we press it up like this. So one side of this, and then we're going to switch sides, same thing on the other side. Then we're going to come into a normal plank, arms parallel on our forearms, and we're going to do hip dips down to one side, then down to the other. So we're in a forward plank, but those alternating hip dips are really going to hit the obliques to finish up. So side one, side two, then a little something for both is basically how it's going to work. And then we rest at the end, not in between the exercises again. So when you guys are ready, let's go ahead and start with that side plank. I'm going to start with my left side. We have 40 second intervals. Get ready. 10 seconds and we're in. Stack that shoulder. Keep which option. Maybe start with the knee and then see if you feel good. And let's go up. 3, 2, 1. Hips touching the ground. And then press up strong. Right under here. You want to push our hips to the ceiling. Keep that shoulder away from the ear and nice and strong. Seconds, then we're in a forward plank, arms down. Switch in 3, 2, 1, right into forward plank. I want to see arms parallel, so don't cross the hands, keep them wide, and then hip dips. Either side, just pivoting on those toes to bring the hips down and out to the side. One more time. So one of each of those moves we just did. Then we're done with abs. We're going to go come back to glutes to finish up. All right, 20 more seconds of rest here. Those hips touch and then nice and strong all the way up. If you find your hips are sagging, just drop that knee and it's still going to be a great workout. Nice one.
this. We're gonna switch in 10 seconds. Three, two, one, right down to that forward plank, arms parallel, let's go. Those hips come down into the side, down and out. Last 15 seconds to go, stay nice and strong, keep it up. And 3, 2, 1, come on, drop, release. Good, done with abs. Let's go back to glutes a little bit. So first, we're gonna start out with something a little bit more mind-muscle connection type. So we're down, stomach to the ground, and what we're gonna do is a glute extension. We wanna squeeze our glutes up and then down, that's it. So really squeezing the glutes just to point the toes, bring them up. Then, we're gonna do some standing sets. So we're gonna do a triple pull sumo squat. A little bit wider than the hips, hips down. One, two, three pulses, squeeze it up. You can see my feet are angled a little bit farther out. Tell me, squeeze into my glutes a little bit more. All right, then, so instead of coming back behind us to the lunge, we're gonna come a little bit out to the side and then up. And that little side angle is gonna help us get a greater stretch in our glutes, and it's gonna be more of a glute movement than quad. And that is what we're gonna finish up. We're gonna go back to those longer 1 minute intervals here. All right, so 10 seconds. Let's get down on our stomachs. All right, get ready for those extensions. 3, 2, 1. So drop the head, squeeze. Really just elevating those knees off the ground. Your hips, squeezing the glutes to do so. This is another one that you want to really hold that glute extension at the top. See if you can while you're at the top. Tap your toes together. See how that feels a little different. Fifteen more seconds, then we're going to stand up. And 3, 2, 1. Go ahead and stand up as quick as you can. Let's get those wide feet angled out slightly, and let's do the sumo squat. So sitting down and back, little pulses, nice and low. That's one. So three pulses at the bottom. 1, 2, 3. See if you can pulse with your hips nice and low. So parallel with those knees if you can. Keeping it up. And what you want to do is like press your knees out wide if you come up. Don't let them cave in because that's your glutes working. So really keep those knees out wide. That's it, a little baby pulses. Can you pulse a little bit lower? Squeezing the glutes the whole time. All right, curtsy lunge, left side in 5 seconds. Get ready. 3, 2, 1. So now point the toes straight forward ahead of you, and then we're gonna come back right at that angle. Stepping. It's these little tweaks that we do to our staples. We want to train glutes, we don't have to make it complicated. We stick to the moves we know, lunges, squats, extensions. But it's just that way we add those little tweaks, like the curtsy lunge, just to make it a bit more of a glute movement. Plenty more seconds to go when we switch right leg.
All right, 3, 2, 1, right side. Bring that right leg in.
Okay.
And think about sitting back, that little twist, and really press up with that glute, digging that heel into the ground. Chest stays up nice and tall. We're back into our glute extensions for the next minute. So get ready to drop down to the floor in 10 seconds. All right, 3, 2, 1. Down to the ground. All the way, let's hit those glute extensions. Squeezing it up, nice pause, really hold that there. Lowering down slow. Keep it up right here. Build that connection. Squeeze it. Ten more seconds. Up next, we got up in the air. Triple pull squat. 3, 2, 1. Feet wide. Let's do that sumo squat. 3 pulses. Up. Remember, our heels make contact with the ground at all times. Our core is braced. Try and keep your chest up as much as possible. Lots of things to focus on, just reminders. Try and get those hips back and down. Keep it up. Keep going with those triple pulses here. Curtsy lunge is next. 15 seconds. Three, two, one. Curtsy lunges. Stepping back into the side. Nice, really maintain that stretch in the glute, a slight angle forward. Pressing, digging that heel in. Halfway through, so we have 30 seconds left, then we're going to the right side, curtsy lunge. Stepping up, toes pointed straight ahead of you. Down to the ground. squeezing out, pointing the toes all the way up. Get those feet up. Little pauses at the top, that makes all the difference. Keep it up. Stay strong. Tighten the low back. Tighten the glutes. Controlling the movement whole time. Can you press your hips a little closer to the floor? Up for triple pulse sumo squats in 5 seconds. Let's get another good rep in. And 3, 2, 1. Hips down and back. There we go. If you can. Nice, reaching back into the side. 20 more seconds of left side, right side's next. Keep it up, knee over ankle. Get ready to switch. 3, 2, 1. Last 60 seconds right here. So I'm gonna get that. And let's go ahead and bring our heart rate down a little bit. We're gonna stretch it out. So grab something for balance if you need to. We're gonna stretch out the quad to start. So bringing that foot back behind us. So releasing all down through the front of that leg. Switch. Opposite leg up. Oh, All right, now let's stretch out the glute, of course. So grab your thing for balance if you need it. If you have great balance and don't need it, that's great too. So cross your ankle over your knee, and we're just gonna sink down like we're doing a little mini squat. And you should feel it in the glute of that top leg. All right, go ahead and switch. Awesome job, you guys, today as well. Yeah, this class is normally taught by Mallory, of course. If you guys come every week, you know that. My name is Devon, and I normally teach fit and strength on different days, but I was just covering today, and Mallory will be back next week. All right, let's stretch out the hip flexor now. So feel it down into low lunge, and then knee drops down right here. Long, big stretch. All right, go ahead and switch sides here. Really sink into it, trying to square the hips as well. That can help. Now we're gonna straighten the legs, shift the weight back, and just hinge at the hips, keeping that leg straight, maybe walking your hands, little inching them closer towards the heel, little by little. Feeling that release all down the back of the hamstring. All right, go ahead, switch legs. Let's stretch the opposite hamstring. Yeah, core and glutes, really important muscles to train. They actually go hand in hand so well because glutes are attached to the core and they kind of help stabilize our lower body a lot, like our core stabilizes a lot as well. And now we are going to sit back into a child's pose. Hips back, reaching long with our arms down. Knees wide, releasing. Go ahead and sink back into that, walking hands out. Coming up, nice long stretch of the upper body. Great work, everybody. Thanks again for coming. Any questions, let me know. I'll be here. You can send me a chat or you can just speak out. And that is it for today. Have an amazing rest of your day.